Hello everyone, welcome back to your Ivy101 course. Today's video we will learn how to create primary segmentations of our mesh graphs. We have four different type of algorithms. The first one is called single root graphs, parsing, which are these three different components. We have disjoint sets, which are using Kruskal's algorithm. We've got the multi-root sets, which are the three components, and the complex agents. We will go through this very quickly, so let's get started. First, we got the edge weight depth first component. I will turn this off and connect this to here. Right click, weights. Put it off. Okay, so this is the weight, edge weight. So firstly, we specify a single start phase at which the drift segmentation will begin, and this will pass through all the lowest weight edges through the graph, and we'll start segmenting our graph into trees until we run out of nodes. And then it goes one step back in the whole parsing and looks for the rest of the lowest weight edges until it runs out of nodes. Next, we got the Prim's algorithm, which is a very good multi-purpose algorithm. We define the start phase by setting any slider, any mesh phase we want. There we go. So Prim's algorithm, it starts from a node and grows in all directions and looks for all the lowest weight edges until it runs out of nodes. And then we got the Dishka algorithm, which works pretty much like the Prim's algorithm, but the difference is that it makes decisions not only based on the current edge, but it evaluates the whole tree, the spanning of the tree, in order to make decisions. This is why these algorithms are called minimum spanning tree algorithms. It looks for the minimum spanning. This is a good algorithm for, the Dishka algorithm for minimal spanning trees, sorry. These are single root algorithms. Next, we got the disjoint sets, which are based on Kruskal's algorithm. These sets of algorithms, we don't need to specify a starting phase. Each node looks for the lightest neighboring edges and in avoiding the not visited nodes, and looks for the lowest weight edges until it runs out of nodes. We got also another input here to specify a domain of the weights we want to consider or not in our tree segmentation. We can also implement this algorithm by considering the concavity or the convexity of our graph edges. There we go. I'll turn this off. I'll just a simple enhanced view. There we go. The thing is that we got this interval input where we set a domain between 0 and 2. This let us consider if we want to only consider the convex or concave graph edges. We can also get the Kruskal valence algorithm, which is, Kruskal's algorithm again, but we can specify the valence of each of the nodes. I will define the size here. We can also define the size of each tree, which is another advantage of this algorithm. We can control the size of each subgraph. There we go. So we have a smaller value. So I got smaller subgraphs of 10 nodes each. The valence, the maximum valence for each node is 2. Valence is more important in this case than weight itself. It doesn't mean that we won't have nodes of or larger valence than 2. For example, in this case, we got a valence of 3. The thing is that the valence will be more important than the weight, and when the connection is required, even if the valence is larger than the value specified here, which is 2 at the moment, it will create a connection. Next, we got the multi-root algorithms, which work pretty much based on Prim's algorithm, but we can specify different starting faces, not a single one. So we got the concavity first. I will define a few faces, 0 and 50, for example. Okay, 0 seems not to be working very well. But, well, the thing with this algorithm is that it relies a lot on the concavity and convexity properties of all the graph edges. So we rely a lot on that information. So, well, depending on the case, we can use this algorithm. We can also specify the interval of convexity or concavity we want to consider for this segmentation. We got the edge weight, which is basically Prim's algorithm. Prim's algorithm, we specify again the interval of weights we want to consider, but we use multiple roots. There we go. We'll use 0. 0 and 100. Okay. And next we got multi-root node weight, which works pretty much the same way as the last one. But this time we won't consider the edge weight, but the node weight. At the moment, we haven't assigned any node weight, so this algorithm won't work for this geometry, so we will leave this algorithm just like that at the moment. And next we got the complex agents. Complex agents algorithms where we specify multiple roots. We'll use the same ones here. But the difference is that I can specify different behaviors to each root face. I forgot to connect this. Okay. I can specify different behaviors for each root face. We have two different behaviors here. We got the consume interval, which is Prim's algorithm, and explore interval, which is basically a different behavior, which consists on growing to all directions and growing by one unit. And, well, each expansion is made avoiding non-visited nodes. So basically, a consume interval will work for already visited nodes, and an explore interval will work for non-visited intervals. At the behavior input, we will define using a slider with values from 0 to 1. The behavior we want, we can tell it to behave more like explore if we define smaller values than 0.5, and if we define larger values than 0.5, we'll behave more like consume. It's more likely than it's to behave like that. It works a bit in a random manner, but not very random. There we go. Okay. And the show iteration, well, it can show a step at a defined iteration we want. I want the iteration 10, so there we go. So I can tell okay, root phase 0 is behaving more in a consume behavior, which is basically Prim's algorithm. It goes like minimal spanning trees, and this goes more exploring the unvisited nodes, creating more expanding trees, exploring trees. So this is how it works, basically. This works a bit randomly, but not so randomly. And we also got, the programmed agent's behavior, which works pretty much the same way, but the difference is that we don't work with likeliness, we work with concise program behaviors. For example, we'll define here a pattern of booleans. Just behave true, false, false, true, false. This is very random, of course. So behavior means what kind of behavior it will have based on the Boolean. False means explore, and true means consume. So based on Boolean values, we can define the behavior of each of the agents or the root faces. There we go. We will go through this and in more detail later on. But well, this is a very quick overview of how primary segmentation works. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.